Good morning. My name is Tim Rolls. I have the privilege of serving on Coach Joe's Football Advisory Committee. I'm a member of the Fort Worth Club. On behalf of Texas Wesleyan, the Fort Worth Club, I'd like to welcome you to the Davey O'Brien. Today, we're going to talk about the history you're going to make on the field this year. But in this room, there is a lot of history, a lot of players that focused on life and the things that Corey talked about last night. In transitioning, Davey not only was an amazing football player, but he went on and served the country as an FBI agent. That's pretty awesome, if you ask me. He never stopped. The players on the wall, the players we recognize in this room, continued to go on as well. I know right now he's looking down at the players, the coaches, everyone in this room, and he's smiling because you're not only student athletes and coaches aren't only coaching to win championships, you're working on becoming better young men, creating leaders of tomorrow. I'd like to thank you all for being here. Today was made possible by the Fort Worth Club as our host. And Michael Thackerson, I'd like to give you a big round of applause and thank you for making this happen. I'd also like to thank Gwen, who made all of your rooms and your stay possible as well. I'd like to give Gwen a big round of applause. At this time, I'd just like to thank the fellow members of the committee to help put on last night and recognize Riata for hosting us last night. It was a fun night. I'm going to turn it over to the commissioner right now and let you guys get down to business. Have a great day.
Good morning. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Stan Wagnon, commissioner of the Sooner Athletic Conference. It's my pleasure to welcome you to Fort Worth for the first ever Sooner Athletic Conference Football Media Day. No problem. It is what I think is really a great moment in history for this conference. Certainly the Sooner Athletic Conference, we just completed 40 years as an NAIA conference. We've amassed more than 100 national championships, and so there's a lot of tradition and a long storied history in this league. But for us to embark upon becoming a football conference and to be able to provide some stability for years to come for the football programs represented in this room, and for hopefully us to transfer this winning culture that our conference enjoys in these other sports, hopefully we'll transfer that to football. And as we mentioned last night, you know, the goal here is that we're going to come alongside these football programs and hopefully be right there as you grow into championship caliber programs. We look forward to seeing the success that's going to come to this conference based on the work that you guys put in on the football field. There's a lot of thank yous to go around in an event like this, and certainly Tim has thanked our hosts here at the Fort Worth Club, and I want to echo his comments there. But Tim and Gino, and there's a lot of guys on in the background here at Texas Wesleyan that have really rallied to help Coach Joe Prud'homme. And Joe, you've done a great job of organizing this for us. But really, all the folks here at Texas Wesleyan have done a great job of putting their best foot forward. So we want to thank you. I also want to thank a couple of our sports information directors who have really kind of stepped up and filled in the gap this summer, especially with this event. Ryan Keating is a new SID here at Texas Wesleyan and has done a great job of helping us out here locally with the logistics. Justine Gaskamp is our SID at Oklahoma Panhandle State. And she's been very instrumental in helping us to pull off this event as well. And so thank you to all those. I know there's others. Alyssa works out of Justine's office. And so there's others that have contributed, but I want to make sure that we thank those who have put in a great deal of work. The conference has hired a new sports information director, and that's Rich Tortorelli. He also serves at Oklahoma City University, but he'll be heading up the information director position for the conference, and he's here today. So Rich, thank you for being here and for the work you're about to do. Tim Crowley is here. He is the football supervisor of officials for the Sooner Athletic Conference, and so those of you in the media who might want to be getting a story about rule changes and points of emphasis from an officiating standpoint, he's here to be of service to you today, so I would encourage you to talk to him. Tim, we thank you for what you're going to do with SAC football. We know that the officials you represent do things the right way, and we look forward to working with you. So with that said, I know you guys are here for a different reason than to just hear me speak all morning, so I want to go ahead and get into the business at hand. What we'd like to do at this Media Day event is to announce to you the preseason poll. And this poll was voted on by the 9 head coaches in our league. Each of them cast their ballots. They were not permitted to vote for their own team. Once we reveal the poll, they're going to announce 3 preseason individual awards for the preseason Offensive Player of the Year, Defensive Player of the Year, and Special Teams Player of the Year. So hopefully by the time we make these announcements, you'll have a good idea of what our coaches are expecting on the field this fall. And obviously, as we all know, it doesn't always go that way, but certainly we get a feel for how things are going to start. So without any further ado, let's go ahead and take a look at the 2018 Sooner Athletic Conference football preseason poll. Those of you in the room, we've got the poll displayed on our TV screens over here. Taking the top spot in this year's poll with 7 first place votes and 63 total points is the Lions from Langston University. Langston completed the regular season last year unbeaten, 10-0 record, and they are entering the 2018 season as the SAC favorite. We had a tie for second in the poll. First, with 1 first place vote and 51 total points, is Arizona Christian. ACU won the Central States Football League in 2015 and 2016. So they certainly know what it takes to win a conference championship. Tying for second also, again, 1 first place vote and 51 points total, Southwestern Assemblies of God. The Lions there, again, tied for second with ACU in the preseason poll. Next, we have in fourth place, Oklahoma Panhandle State. The Aggies had 46 total points. We had another tie for fifth place. Tying for fifth, first of all, was Lion from Arkansas with 30 points, and also Wayland Baptist from Plainview, Texas with 30 points as well. Rounding out the poll in seventh place, first-year program Ottawa of Arizona with 22 points. Eighth place, Texas College with 16 points, and in ninth was Texas Wesleyan with 15 points, second-year program there for Texas Wesleyan. So that's the preseason poll, and what we'll do once I make these announcements on the awards is I'm going to turn it over to Jesse Godding, and he's going to let you hear directly from these teams and their players that are here to represent the program, and we're going to do that in reverse order of the poll. So you'll hear from Texas Wesleyan first, on up through the poll, and hear from Langston, our predicted champion. You'll hear from them last. So the next thing we want to do is announce our preseason individual awards for the conference. We're going to start with the preseason Offensive Player of the Year in 2018, and that award goes to C.J. Collins, quarterback from Southwestern Assemblies of God. Now, C.J. is a senior out of Bosqueville. Last year passed for over 2,800 yards and 26 touchdowns. So congratulations, C.J. He was also the Offensive Player of the Year last year in the CSFL. Our 2018 preseason Defensive Player of the Year goes to Nate Leithed, a linebacker from Panhandle State. Nate is a junior out of Colorado Springs, Colorado, and he was able to pick up 69 tackles last year, 32 unassisted. He had 2.5 sacks and an interception, and was a second-team All CSFL selection. On the preseason Special Teams Player of the Year, we have Ignacio Gomez, who is a sophomore punter and kicker out of Lyon College. He makes his home in Wilmer, Texas, and last year during his freshman campaign, Ignacio was able to make 9 of 12 field goals, 37 out of 39 extra points, and he also averaged nearly 40 yards handling the punting chores for Lyon College. So That's your three individual award winners as we head into the season. I will let you know that both CJ is here, our offensive player, and Nate is here, our defensive player. So you guys have a chance to talk with them individually once we get through the program. So at this time, I am going to turn it over to Jesse Godding. And let me first say that as Jesse comes up, he's the director of athletics at Southwestern Assemblies of God. He also serves as the AD's liaison to our football coaches and in the sport of football in the Sooner Athletic Conference. And he has been as instrumental as anyone in administering this transition of these teams into the Sooner Athletic Conference, and has been a great help to me and someone I've enjoyed working alongside. And so, Jesse, we appreciate you stepping in to lead this part of the program. And once the nine teams have come up and participated, we'll then have an open interview session to where those of you here in the media will make the players and coaches available to you to get any one-on-one interviews that you want to get after the program's ended. So thanks again for being here, and Jesse, it's all yours.
Thank you, Commissioner. Welcome to everybody. Let's get to the part that we want to do here of Texas Wesleyan. If they coaches and players would join me on the stage here. Coming up is head coach Joe Prud'homme, and he's in his second year at Texas Wesleyan. And then joining him as players are Donovan Isom, the QB. He's a senior from Destrehan, Louisiana, and Mike Miller, who's a cornerback, who's also a senior from Plano, Texas. So Coach Prud'homme, entering your second year with Wesleyan football, and having started the program, so I say second year, but really third, I think you've been working at it that long. What's your opening remarks, or what would you have for us at beginning year two?
Well, I would say last year we learned a lot on the field, what it took to compete in the conference, the speed of play, the athletic level that goes along with it, what it takes to really get the program in place. We had a lot of turnover. We overhauled a lot of things we were doing. We decided to speed up the offense, go to up tempo, and we had to get some players to do that. So we have a lot of new faces, offensively, defensively. Got a new coordinator, Kyle Cox. Really excited about him, and had a great recruiting season. So we feel like we put ourselves in a good position for this coming year.
Good. You know, you were one of the ones when we were talking about this in April. I mean, you came forward and said, hey, let's do this thing in Fort Worth. Let's get this going. And obviously, what you've done here is just tremendous. And so how does that, doing this here in Fort Worth, having exposure in Fort Worth, how has that helped your program?
Well, it helps with visibility. It helps with, I think, the entire league and the market this size. And we have a lot of guys in this back row, you know, like Tim and our advisory council that, They do a great job, and they're the ones that have put us ahead off the field in allowing us to put a better product on the field. And so that, to me, was very, very critical for us to get this as high profile for the league as possible, because whenever we're playing a non-conference game, any of our teams, I root for that team, because we got to get to a point to where we're in the playoffs, where we're making noise every year. I just thought this would be something that could help us get to that goal.
Coach, last year I'm sure you had a set of expectations as a first-year program. This year, how have team goals or expectations changed the way you're talking to players for the second year, knowing what's in front of you?
Well, basically, it's what we've told them is our direction is straight up. We were at the bottom. We played poorly. Had a lot of injuries, a lot of challenges. The way we're talking about now, we're not there to just compete. We're there to win, there to put something out there that people have to really plan for and get ready for. Because right last year, we weren't, and we knew that. But I feel like we've made some big, big strides, coaching-wise, player-wise.
Okay, Donovan, I got a question for you. You're coming in and you're being asked to be the leader of the Rams offense, new coordinator. You got a couple of seasons already under your belt at Southeastern Louisiana. So how did your time at Southeastern Louisiana prepare you for where you're at now and to be the starter this season?
It's just preparation, hard work, and you know, just being disciplined and just paying attention to what my coach would be telling me. And I think from that fresh Southeastern transition to the Texas Wesleyan was pretty easy.
Thank you. Mike, you guys defensively, I mean, at times you were pretty salty last year. So this year coming in, what are your goals individually? And then defensively, what goals do you have?
Defensively, we want to work as a unit. Last year, we didn't make a lot of plays that we should have. Missed a lot of tackles, gave up a lot of third down conversions. So I think as a team, we want to focus on stopping teams on third down, getting off the field, helping our offense out.
How about individually?
Individually, I just want to improve from last year. There's a lot of plays that I could have had that I didn't last year, so that's my sole focus for individual goals.
Okay, now you've played all the teams in the CSFL last year. So going into this year, is there one game that you're particularly looking forward to or one opponent that you really enjoyed playing?
I'm looking forward to all the opponents that we play. So.
Well, gentlemen, thank you for your time and best of luck in the 2018 season. And as these guys are dismissed, we'll ask for the Texas College players and coach to come up. Coming up for Texas College, I could sharpen that bow tie, is head coach Charles Moss, who's also in his second year at Texas College. And then joining him is an offensive lineman, Forrest Goodrich, senior from Houston, Texas. And then Montel Barry is D lineman, who's a senior from Duncanville, Texas as well. And coach, just give us some opening remarks for your second year and where Texas College is headed this year.